Today, I will introduce a very popular visual model called Qwen-3VL. This model actually has many enhanced capabilities. For example, it includes a visual agent that can operate our computers and even our mobile phones. Additionally, it has visual code generation capability. It features more advanced spatial recognition ability, such as judging the position of objects. It also possesses longer context understanding capabilities and multimodal reasoning capability. Furthermore, its visual recognition ability has been significantly improved. Improvements have also been made to OCR and text comprehension ability based on large language models. These enhancements actually make it the most advanced visual model currently available. So, what do we use this model for in video or image generation? Primarily, it is used to generate prompts. Now, let's see how to use this model within ComfyUI. To do this, you need to install an extension called ComfyUI QWFall. This extension currently supports the entire series of QW models, ranging from the smallest 2B model to the largest 32B model. The version we are primarily using now is the 4B Instruct model. This is because, in terms of model size and overall performance, this model offers exceptional balance. Everyone first needs to install this extension. The installation method is quite standard. We enter the custom node section, clone it down, and then install the required dependencies. Next, I will use several workflows to demonstrate the surprises this model brings in the realm of video generation. Specifically regarding prompt creation, I have also built the workflows on Running Hub. You can access this platform via Running Hub, I in the ComfyUI space. Running Hub is an excellent online workspace. This is because whenever new extensions or new technologies emerge, it follows up immediately. You can register for Running Hub using the invitation link in my video description. This will grant you 1,000 free credits. Additionally, logging into Running Hub every day will give you a bonus of 100 points. This allows you to test out your own workflows. Let's first look at generating a video based on an image. Next, let's briefly analyze this workflow. This workflow is a standard one 2.2 text-to-video workflow. Some of you might be wondering, didn't I just say this was an image-to-video workflow? This workflow actually takes an image, uses our QWM-VL model to reverse engineer and generate a prompt, and then uses that prompt to generate a video. The most crucial part is the prompt generation itself. Let's first look at the generated result. First, observe the reference image. The reference image has a very exquisite composition. A beautiful woman seems to be pulling back a curtain and secretly looking outside. It possesses a strong sense of visual and narrative depth. Look at the video result, it has a very strong sense of motion. This is noteworthy because most videos generated by standard WAN 2.2 text-to-video workflows tend to have very simple actions. However, you will notice that this video has relatively more actions. This is because it includes the action of pulling back the curtain along with more bodily movements and expressions. What does this depend on? It depends on the generation of our prompt. This prompt is a Chinese prompt. You can briefly look at its structure. The structure is actually a JSON format prompt. Using JSON format prompts results in greater accuracy. Of course, you can also use an English prompt. Let's examine the effect of an English prompt. This is our reference image. It is portrait oriented. It primarily features very beautiful lighting and shadow. Let's look at the generated video. The generated video is landscape oriented. However, you will find that the overall composition, the expression of light and shadow, and the character's hairstyle and clothing are essentially consistent. Take a look, this is the English version of the prompt. But whether it is the English or Chinese version, they are both in JSON format. This JSON format prompt was generated using the QWE model. The most critical aspect here is writing a very professional prompt engineering text. How do you write this? I have already prepared it for everyone. These two prompt engineering texts are for reverse engineering images to generate prompts. One of them is the Chinese version, and the other is the English version. The beginning of this prompt engineering section involves defining a role. It defines you as a highly experienced conceptual designer for films and a video generation expert. Your task is then to generate a highly professional and detailed video prompt based on the image I provide. Furthermore, it must be returned in JSON format, and I specified that the video should be 5 seconds long. I set up a standard JSON format for it. This format covers settings for the shot, the subject, the scene, visual details, and lighting and color tone. These elements collectively define the video. This high dimensionality makes the reverse engineering process more accurate. The shot section includes composition and camera type. The subject section contains a basic description of the subject. The scene section includes location, time, and environment, along with other elements. For each item, I have provided an accurate description below. This helps Qwn-VL understand exactly what needs to be written in the prompt. You can simply copy this entire prompt engineering text into the designated area. Regarding the usage of this node, the only thing to note is that when selecting the model, you can choose either 4B instruct or 4B instruct FP8. After this, we will obtain a prompt like this. This is the English prompt we just discussed. A key element within this prompt engineering is what we just mentioned. The video will have more dynamic motion. Why does this happen? Notice that my prompt engineering includes specific elements. Firstly, there is the action field, which generally describes what kind of video it is. Secondly, there is something called the action sequence. What is the action sequence? I provide an explanation below. It is designed to enhance the sense of motion in the 5-second video we generate. Therefore, based on the image, we expand our thinking to design a sequence of key actions. Furthermore, I requested that it design one action per secant. If we look at the generated prompt, it will contain this specific information. For instance, what action occurs from 0 to 1 secant, and what action occurs from 1 to 2 secants. Thus, the resulting description of actions is much more detailed than if you were to write a single standalone prompt. Next, let's look at the second example. The second example is essentially reverse engineering a video to generate a prompt and then generating a corresponding video. The content is similar to the previous example, but the prompt engineering has slight modifications. Let's look at the result. First, the scene is very beautiful. A woman is walking the red carpet, surrounded by many reporters. Now look at the generated result. Isn't it highly similar? This type of video has a specific characteristic. The movement is simple. Such simple videos are effortlessly replicated with extremely high precision when we reverse engineer them and try to copy them. Every detail is perfectly rendered. Next, let's examine this prompt engineering text. The beginning is essentially the same. The difference is that we are now providing a 5-second video, and we wanted to generate a high-quality prompt based on that video. When generating the detailed action sequence, I now specifically requested that it analyze the provided video in detail and try its best to highly restore the action of every second. This is why we achieve such an excellent restoration or replication effect. However, you must note that, as we just discussed, WAN 2.2 has limitations when rendering complex movements. For instance, let's switch to a relatively complex video. This video shows an oriental beauty traversing a lotus pond in a small boat. Now look at the generated result. You'll find that the character's overall state, clothing, and environment are fine. However, regarding the action, we only managed to capture the movement of her hand reaching into the water to touch the water or the lotus leaves, but it failed to present complex movements like camera motion. When the action is quite complex, models like WAN 2.2 can likely only capture one key action. To illustrate this point, let's look at the final example. Look at this video. It features a very beautiful Western woman wearing a suit of armor and a blue cloak. A child comes over and hands her a letter. This action and scene are quite complex. Now I generate a video through prompt reverse engineering. Take a look. The character's appearance, wearing the cloak and armor, and holding the letter are all reflected. Regarding the action, we can see she is reading the letter. However, you will notice that the action of the child coming over and handing her the letter cannot be captured. However, it created a similar scene where a person walks by. This is similar to the original scene where the child runs away. These are the two scenarios we frequently use. Actually, there is one more very important scenario that people might easily overlook. Since this model is called Qwn-VL, people assume it must always be connected to video and images. That is not entirely true. It can be V, or it can be L, if it acts as L. It is purely a language model. Therefore, you can have it generate prompts directly. I have also placed this prompt engineering text here. Take a look at the subject prompt generator. Both Chinese and English versions are available here. Let me reiterate, this is similar to the image reverse engineering prompt generation. The only difference is that the previous one relied on an image, while this one generates prompts based on a specific subject that I provide. Next, let's look at how the prompt is written, focusing on this section. What is the subject? The subject I wrote here is a beautiful girl in the wind. Look at the generated result. The entire environment setup, camera movement, character actions, and the feeling of the wind are all displayed excellently. Similarly, I created a scenario involving an oriental character. This video was created based on the subject, an oriental beauty walking in a rainy lane in Jiangnan. This video generation was actually quite unsuccessful. Rainy Lane in Jiangnan refers to a misty, drizzling atmosphere. But you will find this type of language model does not have a comprehensive knowledge base. It doesn't actually know what the rainy lane in Jiangnan scenario looks like. Therefore, it merely presents a visual representation based on the literal meaning of the words. Thus, everyone should clearly recognize that, while the capability is strong, the model size is limited, and there is an upper bound to its power. We have introduced the usage of the QWO model through three video generation scenarios. What is one scenario we haven't covered? That is reverse engineering an image to generate a prompt and then generating a new image. Since that is relatively simple, you can try it yourself. Alright, that is all for today. What are you waiting for? Go ahead and try it yourself. Follow me and become someone who understands AI.